Hispanics causing panics.
Shout out to Hispanics causing panics.
Hispanics are causing panic, baby. Let's do it.
Kid Austin, you talk about Kid Austin. Hello, man. When you talk about Kid Austin and coming there and seeing him get down, I mean, you know, we had to tell Kid Austin to get back in the ring after a round. You dig what I'm saying? We had to tell him get back in that ring, man. You see what I'm saying? We do not be playing in this shit, man. You see what I'm saying? He got stopped fucking with us, man. You
dig who what got stopped?
Listen, oh, who said it? Hold on. Now, wait a minute.
We didn't get no stopped or nothing.
We can call my man right now, Kurt, and Kid got out the ring, and we had to tell him get back in the ring for another round. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, but it's all sparring. I want to hear. Look. Okay. What I want to see is this. Bill.
Hold on. Let his father reply.
Okay.
Back in the ring when y'all told him get in the ring. And even when Devin started hitting him dirty and low, Kid Austin said, I still come on at 18 years old. So I'm not saying anything wrong with that.
It was only two rounds.
Hold up. But Kid Austin going in at 18 with a champion.
Okay, after the first round, he got out. We had to tell him get back in there, and for the second
round, he didn't get out.
He got near the
first
round,
he didn't get out.
Okay, so
you making that up? You said in the first round, Kid Austin got out that move. Kid Austin got out the ring and didn't get stopped by no Devin. And then when we asked how to spar 2 days later, you said, no, before we go in the ring with him, we need both hands.
You want me to be brutally honest?
Be brutally honest. He made up some lies.
Yeah, he made up some lies because, you know, I went all three rounds. You know, I was tired, but I still kept pushing. But the first two rounds, you know, Devin couldn't even hold me. You know, I even buckled him in the second round. They got the video.
Damn right.
And.
So let me clear that. He said he buckled him in the second round.
Whole entourage got quiet, too.
It's church masses. Okay, we don't normally tell about our spawn, but he called us out. So my son wanted to defend his honor. But let me tell you.
Why the fuck you lying? Why you always lying? Oh my God. Stop fucking lying.
Orale raza, G-fucking boxing of HCP. That's Hispanics causing panic. Make sure if you're new to the channel, you like the video. Subscribe and hit the notification bell so you know every time I go live. Every Wednesday, 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific, HCP Uncensored. Come get this. Smoke anytime. Man. I want to give some credit to Punch Drug Boxing and Raw Boxing TV for providing the footage that you just seen here. This seems to be a thing going on with Bill Haney. Always going around talking about these sparring sessions, about other beating people up, stopping people, and this and that. Look, man, I always kind of knew that you were over-exaggerating things, but now you're just flat-out lying about stuff, man. And Kid Austin's dad called you out. Kid Austin and his dad made a video calling you out. They even called the guy you said that they should call until he was there, and he'll tell you about all the stuff that happened. And he didn't co-sign with anything you were saying. You know, if anything, he said it was good work from both guys, and both guys did good. Nobody got stopped or anything like that. You know, this is crazy stuff, man. But this dude is going around every channel that'll listen to him and say things like this. And some of these channels will believe him. You know, like I've never fully believed any of this stuff, and now I realize it. And you know, I was already kind of realizing it because you're going to see here in some of the footage that I'm going to play from our podcast, Hispanics Causing Panic podcast, every Tuesday, 9 Eastern, 6 Pacific on D-Style Boxing here on YouTube. Also on the Leave It in the Ring Network, iTunes, Pandora, iHeartRadio, all the podcast platforms out there. But you'll see that, when Kid Austin's dad said they don't really talk about their sparring, that's true. Because, you know, I tried to ask the young kid about it. And, you know, he just was very humble and said, you know, hey, you know, I had good work. They were all good work. I even asked Sam Arnold because it looked like he might have sparred with Devin Haney. They took some pictures together and he said no. But I sparred one of their guys and they tried to edit some footage and say that I quit and stuff like that. I mean, this is just garbage, man, to do this type of stuff to these young kids, man, 18 years old, 17 years old, these kids. You know, this is garbage. This is dumpster juice, man, is what this is. And, you know, the thing is this, man, I don't know who or why anybody would want to go down there and work with Devin Haney now when you got things like this happening. These guys lying about stuff, editing footage and things like that. Like, you guys are only hurting yourselves with this, man, I think, you know? And I would just suggest, hey, look, just be honest about shit and everything will be okay. All right. But it was full on cap season for Bill Haney, and he got his cap knocked off his head. So that's really all I got to say about it. I'm gonna play some of the footage from our interview with Kid Austin and Sam Arnold. They talk about the sparring session. So that's all I got, guys. Enjoy the videos, and I'll see you on the next one.
Tell us a little bit, man. How are the experience getting in the ring and sparring with these professionals, man?
The experience is good. And, like, I ain't going to say too much, but I held my own. So, you know, it showed me It showed me the type of level I'm on. And, like, I'm up there with them. And, you know, being with them is a great experience. And it's actually fun. So, and I get to learn new things from them.
Who was the out of all those guys you sparred, who was the toughest for you, man?
I wanted to ask you too.
All of them.
I want to ask you something, man. I seen you had some pictures in the gym with Devin Haney. Now, he's been a part of some famous sparring sessions in the last couple of years. Have you been in there and sparred with him in the gym?
No, but I sparred against one of their guys, though. Got kind of crazy, but you know, I went there and sparred against one of the guys that he's supposed to be signing, who I actually fought to. It was cool, but they had a lot of people just cheering against me, and then they posted something on YouTube to make it look like I quit in sparring and stuff, but it wasn't that at all. You know, I never quit in no sparring. The dude not even good enough to even make anybody quit. So
there you go. All right.
Seems to be a thing nowadays. You know, I remember going to the gyms, local gyms here in my city, with friends and family that were training and amateurs and stuff. And, you know, sparring never really was a big deal, but all of a sudden now it's become like a big sensation for some reason. I don't understand it. Do you know what that is, what that's about, or anything like that?
It's really them just trying to give an image to everybody else to make them believe that that's how they are. I believe they're trying to sell an image to me, but I don't really get into all that. I just, like, when I work, it just be like work. I won't post a lot of sparring. I'll probably post a little clip every now and then, but that type of work, like, I wouldn't post anything. But they posted stuff, so we had to post ours, man. Whenever that came out, we were sending people the whole link of the full sparring. And Fight Hype came and recorded and everything. They just never released it because they know what it really was.